it's gone fairly well. We haven't had any major challenges. Actually, let me restart that. We've had a lot of major challenges. Now that I think about that. So when we first visited our manufacturing partners, I got up in front of a room of about 20 people and pitched this concept, this idea that we could build a laptop unlike any of the other ones that they've ever built. And they looked at that concept and said, "We can't do this. There's no way we can do this. It's just not going to work."
Nirav Patel set out to take on the tech giants like Apple and Microsoft by creating a new kind of laptop, one that was better for the environment and for the people using it.
Apple is a complicated company in that they've picked a design philosophy that really emphasizes the idea that these products are perfect and shouldn't be modified or upgraded or repaired in any way. And the business models of these companies now depend on this, that these products need to wear out so that you can push more new ones out into the market. You're basically borrowing a product on the way to the landfill. I needed to go and fix this because it wasn't going to fix itself.
Nirav created Framework, a startup that's making tech products so easy to repair that you might not have to buy a new laptop ever again.
So my parents were immigrants from India, and they really brought the immigrant mindset of self-sufficiency. And so growing up, anytime anything was broken around the house, we would just try to fix it ourselves. And that always gave me this sort of insight of, if you see a problem, you can't actually just pick up the wrench or the screwdriver and fix it.
Nirav went on to become the head of hardware at Oculus.
The idea behind Framework sort of built in my mind over the period of the last decade, looking around and seeing the kind of weird things happening in consumer electronics, things that didn't make any sense to me. They were sort of inherently these one-off temporary objects when they didn't really have to be. It should be that when you buy a product, you can use it for as long as you'd like to by being able to repair it and upgrade it and modify it to meet your needs.
This is the Framework laptop. Nearly every component in the computer can be swapped out with a simple screwdriver.
Everything is just a single layer. So we've got one layer of modules here with the keyboard, the touchpad, and the fingerprint reader, and then one layer on the inside here, and everything is accessible and nothing's kind of buried inside.
We want consumers to feel like the product is theirs. It's not our Framework laptop, it's their laptop, and they can do whatever they'd like with it.
Upgrading storage, replacing the display, or even switching out what ports the computer has is trivial with Nirav's laptop design. But the Apples and Microsofts of the world don't agree that the right to repair is something that consumers should have access to.
One of the opposition arguments given by manufacturers is that right to repair represents a threat to the security of our devices. While on many levels I am an Apple fan, clearly, I must tell you that permitting a screen replacement or battery charger housing resolder on an iPhone or a Google Pixel is not the same thing as deliberately breaking encryption. It is creating a well-designed machine intended to be reused and repaired.
For decades, the right to repair has been an ongoing legal battle between manufacturers and consumers. The fight over who really owns the products you buy.
The right to repair is incredibly important, and it is actually a core part of what we're doing, because increasingly products are not designed to be repaired. And seeing the response from the community out there, that's what really fuels us, knowing that there are these people just waiting for this product to arrive.
By sharing all the information, parts, and tools necessary to make any modification to the Framework laptop, Nirav and his team are empowering consumers to take back their right to repair.
We hope we can influence the direction of the consumer electronics industry, but we're not counting on our competitors growing a conscience. Their business models almost depend on them not growing a conscience, and so we are doing everything we need to ourselves to make the products that consumers want. And over time, if other companies follow us, that's great. And really, that is towards our mission of having a better consumer electronics industry for the world. Over the next 5 to 10 years, there's really two things that we want to be able to do out in the world. One is that every single framework laptop should still be being used by someone somewhere. We don't want any single one of those to be sitting in a landfill. The other thing that we want in that time frame is to spread from the laptop that we started with out into more and more consumer electronics categories to build a consumer electronics industry that is better for people and for the planet. We see an incredibly broken, massive industry around us, and we know that we can do better. You can have a great idea and pull together an incredible set of people and be able to build something new and interesting and worthwhile, and that actually, not only can you do that, you should do that, because that's the most valuable thing you can do with your time if you're able to.